IIS mini-inverters are some of IOTA's most versatile life safety solutions, capable of powering almost any fixture type at full light output during moments when you need it the most. This video will describe the operation of an IIS inverter under various power conditions and provide an overview of its installation and wiring. For more information about IIS inverter features and benefits, we invite you to view our IIS inverter advantages video by clicking the link in the description or visiting IOTA on YouTube. At the most basic level, an IOTA mini inverter is a battery backup system for designated lighting fixtures. Internally, an IOTA mini inverter includes a valve-regulated lead-acid battery system and the components and circuitry necessary to convert the battery DC output into line voltage. By interfacing between your building's power grid and your emergency fixtures, the IIS inverter will detect any loss in power and supply your fixtures from its internal batteries. Because the IIS inverter provides line voltage, your emergency fixtures will operate as they normally would at full light output, making you sure they will deliver enough illumination during a power loss. IIS mini-inverters also have the advantage of being able to be remote mounted up to 1,000 feet, making them convenient options for decorative or outdoor installations. When remote mounting, be sure to comply with your local and national emergency lighting codes for extended wiring. If your inverter is an IISDR model, it has the added capability of being able to override local 0 to 10 volt dimming controls on your emergency fixtures. More on the IISDR in the wiring section. IIS mini-inverters are designed to be surface mounted in a convenient location to suit your building's design, with the exception of the IIS 125 ceiling grid, which can be mounted above the ceiling tiles. To install a surface mount IIS mini-inverter, first select your desired mounting location. An IIS mini-inverter provides two keyhole slots that can be used for mounting the unit securely to the wall. In addition, a round hole that fits a number 10 screw is located in the cabinet. This screw is required to prevent the unit from being inadvertently lifted off the keyhole slots. Please be sure to not drill any additional holes in the unit and check to make sure it is mounted securely. Do not rely on a junction box to support the weight of your IIS mini inverter. Secure it to the wall directly or mount it on a secure platform. To install an IIS 125 ceiling grid model, first, remove the ceiling tile in the desired installation location and place the unit across the 2-foot T-bars of the ceiling grid. Support your IIS 125 with wires attached to the building's steel framing. Holes are provided at the top of the IIS 125 for this purpose. Do not rely on the inverted T-bar structure to support the unit without the support wires. Once your IIS mini-inverter has been securely mounted, you can begin wiring. To begin wiring your IIS mini-inverter, you first need to identify which fixtures will be used for emergency operation. These fixtures must be placed on a separate circuit than any non-emergency fixtures. Then you will need to extend an unswitched AC feed of 120 or 277 volts to the inverter. This feed will serve as the inverter's battery charging input and the place where it can detect a power loss. Because of this, it is important that this feed remain unswitched. This feed will be connected to the wires inside your inverter labeled input wires. Connect the neutral wire to the white lead. Then connect the line wire to either the black lead for 120 volts, the orange lead for 277 volts, or, if your inverter comes with an orange-black lead, connect it to either 120 to 277 volts. You have now connected the inverter AC input. Next, we will connect the normal power input, which involves the leads inside your inverter labeled flying leads. The flying leads allow the inverter to pass through normal power to your emergency fixtures, enabling them to be used as normal in non-emergency situations. If you do not want your emergency fixtures to be on during normal power conditions, the flying leads will not be necessary and can be capped. To use the flying leads, connect them to the same AC line feed as the input wires or to an alternate AC feed if desired. Connect the white flying lead to the neutral wire. Then connect the black lead to the line wire. If an orange wire is present, connect it instead of the black wire for 277 volt applications. Otherwise, if no orange wire is present, the black wire will be capable of handling 120 to 277 volts. The main advantage of the flying leads is in enabling you to use a wall switch or some other on-off control device on your emergency fixtures. To do this, you will need to insert the inverter between the switch and your emergency fixtures by connecting the line output of the wall switch to the black or orange flying lead instead of connecting the flying lead to the unswitched AC feed. Now, your emergency fixtures can be switched on or off during normal power conditions, and during a power loss, the inverter will ignore the position of the switch and operate your emergency load at full brightness. The next step is to connect the output of the IIS inverter to your emergency fixtures. Connect the gray output wire to the shared neutral wire of your emergency fixtures, then connect the yellow-violet wire to the 120 to 277 volt line wire. Note, be sure to never connect the gray output wire to the white neutral input wire. This can heavily damage your IIS inverter and will void the warranty. If your IIS inverter is an IIS 375, IIS 375 LED, or an IIS 550 model, you will also need to wire the internal circuit breaker. Two wires will be located next to the circuit breaker. Select the proper voltage lead, violet for 120 volts and yellow for 277 volts, and connect it to the circuit breaker. Be sure to match the voltage used to connect to your emergency fixtures and cap the unused lead. Then, push the circuit breaker switch to the closed or on position. After the inverter output wires and the circuit breaker, if necessary, has been wired, your IIS inverter will now be ready to supply power to your emergency load. Before we finish the last steps to wiring, let's first discuss IISDR models. These upgraded mini-inverters contain three additional dimming leads, which allow you to bypass 0 to 10 volt dimming controls on your emergency circuit. To use the dimming leads as a bypass, connect the violet wire from the output of the dimmer control to the brown, normally closed wire of the IIS inverter. Then connect the red common wire from the IIS inverter to the violet wire from your LED load. The blue wire can be capped. Now, during a power loss, the IIS inverter will electrically open the dimming circuit, forcing your fixtures to operate at full lumen output regardless of the dimmer setting. After connecting the dimming leads, your IISDR should now be wired and ready to operate your load. Only two things remain to finish wiring entirely. The first is to ground the unit by connecting the green ground wire inside your IIS inverter to the earth ground. The second is to install the IIS inverter battery. Before installing the battery, be sure to check the torque on the hardware that connects the polarized connector to the terminals, as these connections may have loosened in transit and storage. See your installation manual for the proper torque ratings. IOTA Engineering also recommends that you check this torque on an annual basis. Place the battery inside the IIS inverter with the terminal posts facing towards the front of the unit. Note, that battery is heavy. Be sure to exercise caution when handling it. Once the battery has been installed, you can plug the battery connector together. Your IIS inverter should now be successfully installed and wired properly. As a courtesy, IOTA provides a red emergency circuits label that can be applied to the panel board to identify which circuit contains your IIS inverter. Now we can test the inverter's operation. To test the IIS inverter, first energize your emergency circuit. At this time, the yellow ready indicator light and the red charging indicator light will illuminate, signifying that your inverter is receiving AC power and charging the battery respectively. Now, press and hold the test switch and observe that the green inverter on indicator light illuminates as well. Pressing the test switch causes your IIS inverter to simulate a power loss. Instead of accepting normal power to charge the battery and passing through this normal power to your emergency fixtures, the IIS inverter will switch to providing power to your load via its battery. Any emergency fixtures that were off will now come on or stay on if they were already illuminated. To complete the test, release the test switch. The green inverter on indicator will turn off, and your emergency fixtures will now return to their normal operation. Be sure to allow the IIS inverter to charge for at least 72 hours after installation before conducting a full 90-minute discharge test. Afterwards, continue testing per your local and national emergency lighting code test guidelines. Congratulations! Your IIS inverter has now been installed, wired, and tested. With proper maintenance and adherence to test procedures, you can now be confident that your emergency lighting rests in the capable hands of IOTA's durable inverter technology. To learn more about IOTA IIS inverters or about our other innovative emergency lighting solutions, we invite you to visit us online at iotaengineering.com or give us a call at 1-800-866-4682. As always, we would love to hear about the ways you are using IOTA life safety solutions. If you like this video, be sure to click subscribe below for more tutorials and emergency lighting knowledge. Thanks for watching.